for increasingly desperate Yemenis, Djibouti is becoming a safe haven. But first, they have to cross this to get there. It's the Bab el-Mandeb Strait. It's one of the busiest waterways in the world, and they're making this journey across it in fishing vessels. Often we're told three or four families jammed in at the same time. This is where many end up. Obok, in the north of Djibouti, a quiet little fishing port. In an orphanage under construction, we find Mohammed Hamoud and his wife Amna turning their daily government ration into the family's lunch. They're one of 50 families squeezed into this building site while the official refugee camp is being built. Amna says when her family is sitting eating together like this, she can almost forget what happened the night the aerial bombardment began. Her son Majid described the family's long journey in a rickety fishing boat as a window into hell.
25 نفر في داخل القارب مننا يعني جينا من هناك الساعة 7 صباحا وصلنا هنا الساعة 2 ظهرا
في البحر وتتقلب المركب ومعاكم انتوا عيال صغار
هذا واحد هذا الثاني وهناك في معاهم 7 اطفال من هذولهم 7 اطفال والحريم مطار شي كانوا يعني جعثة.
But not everyone in the family made the journey. Amna's daughters and their families are still in Yemen, cut off from all communication. Talking about it, Amna became too overcome to go on. As the conflict across the water escalates, more and more Yemenis are expected to make this desperate crossing, hoping, like Amna and her family, that it won't be too long before they can turn around and go home. Nima Elbagir, CNN, Obok, Djibouti.